Whoa, hey! Look who snuck in and got their Omicron next now. Wampa. I feel like Wampa is such a random option, though, because he has no synergy. Like, look, categories. Dark Side Attacker. That's it. What's it? So, I don't know. We'll see what this is all about, though. Let's see. Where is it? Okay, it's on Cornered Beast. So, new final text, Omicron. Wampa has plus 50% counter chance. Wampa has plus 10% counter chance, plus 5% health steal, and plus 5% offense for each damage over time effect on each enemy. You know what? I never really paid attention to that before. That would be, he might be pretty good with, like, a Vader team, especially Vader lead. Yeah. Anyhow, while in Grand Arenas, that's good. Grand Arena's a good spot. Wampa gains plus 100% tenacity. That's the whole sentence. okay. I mean, tenacity's decent. It is always annoying when you go up against, like, a Jedi team, and they have either, like, Bastilla lead, or they have Yoda, who already did the, you know, move where he spreads everything around. Because then, if you have Vader or something, you try to put down some damage over time, and nothing happens. I hate that. So that's good for Wampa, not getting any debuffs. Then again, though, it's plus 100% tenacity, so that just means, like, what if he had super low tenacity? It's still gonna suck. You know what I mean? Like, what if you modded him and all he had was, like, I don't know, how does the tenacity rating work? Is it, like, speed? I'm not sure offhand. Let's say it is, like, speed. So say all he had is, like, 80 tenacity. Okay, so now he's got 160. I guess that's actually not bad, because if that was speed... I don't know. Anyways, let's get off of that. If there are no other active allies at the start of battle, Wampa gains plus 75% defense, plus 75% max health, plus 75% max protection, and plus 75% offense, which is doubled if there is only one active enemy at the start of battle. Ah, to call back to him versus Luke, basically. It was one enemy. Whenever Wampa is damaged by an attack, inflict two damage over time effects for three turns on the attacking enemy, which can't be evaded or resisted. Okay, that's cool. That helps out his original portion of this, which is that he'll gain plus 10% counter chance, 5% health steal, and 5% offense. Actually, it'd be 10 because it's per. Right? Yeah, for each. Where was I? Oh, and the cooldown of Furious Foe is reduced by 1. And then gain plus 30% tenacity in stacking until the end of encounter. Okay, so now he'd just be getting super tenacious. Alright, the tenacity is pretty cool, but, like, this is a ridiculous amount of tenacity for what? I mean, I'm pretty sure the plus 100% tenacity is good enough. What's the extra 30 stacking needed for? You know, like, what kind of debuffs is he going to get? What, is he going to be able to resist a fracture? I doubt it. So anyhow, here's what I think about this. First off, like I already said in the very, very, very beginning, he doesn't have any synergy. As such, nobody really uses him. Yeah, when he first came out, people used him in their dark side teams, but that was before GLs and all this other good stuff. Like, it's not that Wampa sucks, it's just he has nowhere to go, so he's kind of pointless to use. It's like Cup. Okay, technically Cup is a Galactic Republic, but you're not going to put him in a Padme team because he's just worthless. I guess that's actually like the opposite of Wampa. Wampa's good, he just has nowhere to go, but you know what I'm trying to say. I mean, all of this stuff that he gets while Grand Arenas is pretty juicy. You know, all the added health, protection, offense, and defense. And then doubling it, so it's 150% if there's only him and an enemy. But, here's the thing. One, like I said, Wampa's never used. And two, if Wampa is in a team, because he doesn't have synergy, he's not getting any of the bonuses. None of the leader bonuses, no nothing. I mean, maybe if you put him with, like, a GL as the lead, but still, like, he's gonna... If you put him with a GL as the lead, then that means you're using a GL to fight that GL, most likely. So, killing Wampa is gonna be simple. So... Yeah, I don't know. My experience when there's Wampas, basically, I kill Wampa right away. Not because I'm targeting Wampa, it's just he doesn't have... He's just easy. Like I said, he doesn't have any of the leader ability bonuses. So, like, say like an Empire team with Papa Palp lead, okay? You get those heals whenever you, what is it, inflict a debuff or something on an enemy? Well, Wampa don't get that. He's not Empire. or Sith, or I don't know. I'm just thinking about, also, this is an Omicron. So Omicrons are something that's very hard to get. It takes forever. Like, for me, I think the last time I laid one down was January. Here we are, beginning of March, and I'm at 18 out of 20. I'm super close to getting my third Omicron, but not yet. But anyhow, I feel like when you finally get an Omicron, you want to put it on somebody that's worth it, like Embo. Embo's was solid. Like, his Omicron benefits the entire team. Or another one is Hera. Hers benefits the entire team. Qui-Gon. Phasma, they all benefit the whole team. This one just benefits him, literally just him. I mean, it's even better for him if it's just him versus just someone else. This is almost as pointless as Krennic's, because Krennic only benefits him and Dark Trooper, or Death Trooper, I mean. Now, I guess in all fairness, I did have a comment on my video that said, you know, a lot of the community are all hating on this Omicron, but it's way better than you think it is, so... Who knows? Maybe the Krennic one's not as crappy as I thought. But still, when you can have a team of five and an Omicron's only benefiting two out of those five, when you could be benefiting all five out of five, it just seems like, is it worth it? Or at least at this time, kind of like this one. This literally only benefits Wampa, and it's so specific. I mean, yes, the 100% tenacity is guaranteed, but you have to have no other active allies. And it's even better if... there's only one enemy, and like the chances of that are way too specific. First off, how would Wampa be by himself, and how would you be going up against only one enemy? Like, I feel like you would have to be struggling then. So you're working on whittling down a team, you finally have one left, and you're like, ooh, I'll throw Wampa in there by himself, hopefully you can do it with all those bonuses the Omicron gives him. Otherwise, this is just way too specific. Because even if you wanted to try to, say you put Wampa in versus, like, I don't know, what's, like, a weak team? Maybe, like, say, like, you got a Relic, I don't know, 7 Wampa, and you want to put it up against a, maybe, like, a Gear 12 or very low Relic'd Ewok team, and you think, yeah, I can probably solo this. Well, the problem is... That's all five. So yeah, Wampa will get those plus 75% bonuses, but he's not going to get the full thing because it's not only one active enemy at the start of battle. Even when you kill the other four and you're down to one left, it wasn't at the start of battle like that. So he doesn't even get the plus 150. So I don't know. Yes, this is pretty good, but it's also way too circumstantially specific. And without the synergy of a team for himself or for this Omicron to work with the team, I just feel like it's kind of... not worth it. And like I said, nobody uses Wampa. Now I get it, putting an Omicron on Wampa could be to try to put some new life into him, because he is kind of a hard character to unlock. I mean, the only areas to get his shards are from the territory battles store, and it uses like the geo territory battle currency. So, you know, it's not like you're just getting Wampas super easy out of, like, say, Squad Arena or not even the Galactic War Store, you know, when you can go in 3 times a day and really get a character beefed up quickly. But I don't know. I don't know if this is where it's at. Let's see what the community says, though. Is the second half of the ability always active, or only if Wampa is solo? Pretty sure if it's only if he's solo. That's how the first half works, so... FYI, Doja has answered this further down. Only the stat gains are dependent on being solo. Thanks, Doja. I would assume it's always active, but because it's CG, I'm not sure. Should be always, yeah. The only active and only one active enemy is for stat boost. At least that's how the description reads. Oh! When he says first one, did he just mean... Wait, what? Is the second half of the ability always active or only... What are you talking about? Second half, is that, are you talking about where it says while in Grand Arenas? Are you talking about if there are no other active allies? Oh, I see, they're talking about whenever Wampa's damaged by an attack, inflict 2 damage over time. Yeah, I thought that was always. Yeah, only the stat gains are dependent on being sold. Yeah, definitely need a clarification there. Seems like it's designed to clean up a lone GL. Interesting. I mean, that's what I was thinking, like, that's what I was saying. If you're whittling down a team, chances are you'd only have that GL left. But I'm like, I don't know if Wampa would still be good enough. GLs are intentionally designed to be super OP, so I don't know. Or a bad omen that 3v3 is returning. If the damage over time was... Wait, what? When damage part is not part of the solo clause, please reorganize the text like this. Blah, blah, blah. Goodbye, mama. Mama. Lol. What the heck is MM? What is MM supposed to be? For clarification purposes, usually, if a restriction is set within a paragraph, then everything within said paragraph that comes after said restriction only applies if the conditions are met. Meaning, the most likely scenario is that if Wampa isn't solo, plus 100% tenacity is all he gets. See, that's what I was thinking too. Because there's a period, so it ends it. That's it. It gets 100% tenacity. Then it says if, like an if-then statement, if there are no active allies at the start of battle. But then it says whenever Wampa is damaged by an attack. There's no if-then with that. It's just saying when he's damaged. So is that pursuant to no other active allies, or is that just its own line? I don't know. I thought both ways. Both people, what they're saying. I see it both ways, so I don't know. At first, I just assumed that the second part was a given, but I don't know. Would be spicy for or if it's always active. What the heck is or? All these dumb abbreviations. Why is this so big? Best Omicron yet. Not really. Yes, it's solid what it gives him, but it only gives it to him and with weird specific circumstances. I don't know if this makes it the best. Not really, unless it's bugged. In this game, the restriction applies to the same sentence. When there is a full stop period, then the rest of the description is independent of the if condition. But I do agree that Drek's boo suggestion is much cleaner and simpler. So said that how it reads, we should all assume the second half is always active, but we always need a clarification because CG doesn't know how to properly write their kit interactions. Lol. All I have to say is... Okay. I post this in the wall. Wait, why not post this in the wall post that is already created? Can't CG just write for clarity assuming the reader has English as a second language? Here's what I got for a response. Wait, what? This is Doja Fat. Is this the real one? Here's what I got as a response. Whenever Wampa is damaged by an attack, inflict 2 damage over time effects for 3 turns on the attacking enemy, which can't be evaded or resisted. The cooldown of fear is supposed to restore 1 and gain plus 30% tenacity stacking until the end of the counter. This happens even if he's not alone. The only thing that's affected by him being alone is the extra stats. Huh. Or maybe 1v1 will... Hey! That could be a thing. I didn't even think of that. 1v1 would be stupid, but you never know. Then that would be a super good Omicron. Great job staying true to the character and giving it a chance to see more action. Don't know if it's worth 20 Omicrons. Do know it will probably cost some rounds failing solo fights, but awesome anyway. The boost in the opponent is... alone is also a nice touch, but it's way too application specific. When are you going up against somebody that's alone? Unless you've already lost to them 15 times, you know what I mean? Like, not 15, but let's say 3 times and or 2 times, and now you're going in on your 3rd time. It's like your banners are already killed. Like, oh, now I'm gonna go in and be OP with this Wampa. Like, thanks for the clarification, Doja. Appreciate it, dear riffing guy. Please no. Huh, Rebels Beware, I guess, maybe? Why? It doesn't say anything about Rebels. It doesn't say it's strong against any faction. It just says if it's 1v1. Can't speak for OP, but personally, what is OP? I read the other thread, and it was full of grumpy posts about semantic quibbles. It just didn't seem to match the love I was feeling for the Wampacron. So I thought they'd leave them to argue over where the comma should go in the description and just dance. What is OP? Speak for OP? Oh my word, how many times are we gonna put this here? What about Wampa gains 100% tenacity, as that's an extra step, but isn't written as needing him to be alone, but hasn't been mentioned in their response? Okay. About the plus 100% tenacity, I always forget, is it a flat bonus? So if I had 40%, now I have 140%, or a relative bonus? I had 40%, so now it's 80%. Same question for potency and CC, basically for every percent stat. What is CC? Plus 100% tenacity. So it just means whatever your tenacity is, you're basically doubling it. So yeah, if you had 40, now you have 80. Flat bonus. Although potency and tenacity are shown as percentage, the way they work in game is not. What? You tell me it's flat? Plus 100, so if you had 40, you have 100. What? That's not how math works. Anyways, yeah, so there it is. Wampa has his Omicron. I mean, it's pretty solid, but it's just, without a proper team and way too application specific, I don't know. I don't want to say I don't like it, but I'm definitely not going to be jumping to put it on him anytime soon either. So, yeah, that's it. Until the next one. Man, this is a weird ending. But anyways, until the next one, I said see ya.